Okay, so to begin, I would say that I came from 4 days, service days in the IDF. We conducted there a workshop that was about how to make the usage of social media more beneficial to our purposes. And we conducted there a team of data scientists and data analysts, like Dave described earlier. And we loved their products, really. I love them very much. I learned from them. They are very young people. But eventually, when we come to conclusions, we can't ignore the most significant factor, which is the human factor. We can't do intelligence without knowing and understanding people. And for me, it strengthened my the notion that I goes with so many years that cyber is all about people. And I think that in my short summary that I'll show you today, the human factor is the most factor, and we have to consider it. So I would like to show you a different perspective of terror groups using the social media, and it is based on media or communication fields, all kinds of research from these fields. And to demonstrate it, I will use ISIS as a terror group, which is well known and proved that they took an advantage on social media and the use of it because they understand one big notion, which is how to use the core business of internet companies such as Facebook, Google, etc. Because of the use of their business model, which is the digital marketing and advertising, and we have to keep it to keep this in mind. So the thesis that I was based on was the article of Bennett and Segerberg from the communication and media area, which is called the logic of connective action. And basically, they speak about the framework of two things, two very important things. The first one is the increasing of public engagement through social media and processes of personalization. Okay, the way that people are express themselves and choose to show themselves in the social media, which is a very personalized process. And the second one is the widely spread content through social media, through variety of measures and applications and devices and so on. So many platforms, and we choose how to manifest ourselves. So the model of logic of connective action is separated into three levels. The first level is the collective action. Now, my demonstration, of course, is about ISIS, so I'll just explain in few words what the model says, and I'll demonstrate it on ISIS. So the collective action, the first level, talks about networks that are mediated by organizations, which means that the organization controls and control the social media that he provide to his people, okay? So it is very centralized. It is very centralized, it is very controlled, and it aims or applied to interpersonal relationship between the parts of the organization in order to conduct content and strengthen the audience to their bonds to the organization. Now, the connection is made for all sorts of activities in the organization, as we know, such as recruitment, propaganda, financing, inspiration for new recruiters, or incitement to other opponents, etc. To see how it works in terms of ISIS, For example, we know that ISIS understands very well the principle of, as I mentioned before, the principle of digital marketing, okay? They know how it works, and by saying that, it means that they know exactly how Facebook or Twitter or Telegram uses their tools, what the tools are meant to be, what are behind the tools, and they take advantage of these measures and tools. So ISIS, for example, by Al Hayat Media Center, targets international audiences by using translation to different languages, European languages and others. Okay, they use, they know how to use videos, traffic, video games, etc., and also the online magazines, not printed one, but on the net. So they use it for a centralized organization coordination. They are very professional in the way that they conduct it. And the use of all these kinds of social technologies is to share and manage the coordination of their goals. And we have to say that ISIS is very unique in this way of acting, because it's an organization that doesn't have any boundaries or geographical territories, as we know about, let's say, Hamas, which is located in a very boundaried territory. So when you are such a global organization or ideological, and you have to spread your ideas all over the world, it means that you have to have these measures that can allow you sending all this content. And by that, it is very controlled, it is very centralized, and this is the first level of collective action. Another example of the collective action, the first level, is the process of recruitment, for example. Okay, so in order to recruit, there are many testimonies of people who recruited new activists into ISIS and other organizations such. And they said that there are three main or major principles in the social media. The first one is the tawhid, which is no God but Allah, and the takfir. The second one is the boycott or declaration of Muslim rulers as heretic. And the third one is the al-wala wal-bara, which is the principle of loyalty to Islam or to the God, and the rejection of whatever is not Islamic enough for them. Now, these three parts, okay, these three principles are manifested in many ways, but the principles are the same. It means that the recruitment process is conducted the same in each, in each country in Europe, or in Canada, or in the US. It's the same process. The manifestation is different between the places. But the basic line or the guidelines are the same. So from here, I will go to the second level, which is the connective action mediated by organization, which means that it is not, the organization is not centralized. It is not about ISIS, but it's about the provinces, okay? The semi-organizations in many, many places all around the world, like Asham, what they call Asham, or Yemen, or Khorasan, or other places that we have many, many organizations. So the second level of connective action mediated by organizations means that they have weak and loose connection to the father organization, but they are relay on the platforms and the infrastructure that ISIS gives them. It means that if ISIS thought that Telegram, for example, is the main channel to spread the content, they will use Telegram, but they will do it in their way, okay? Their expression is very personalized to the place, to the culture of their semi-organization. Now, if to give an example of ISIS, we can speak about the squad of Molenbeek. Molenbeek, sorry, were the homegrown cells from the outskirts of Brussels in Belgium, and they were like it was like a net with loose connections. That was based on geographical, the neighborhood, friendship, etc. Now, some of the members of this group were coordinated with ISIS because they went to the combat fields in Syria, but then they came home and they gathered the members into a squad. One of the manifestations of this group was that each member manifested or expressed himself in a different way, but it was very personalized, okay? And I would say that the most notorious example was of Ibrahim Abdel Salam, who chose directly to he aimed to 8 p.m. Okay, and he stood before a camera in, I think it was near a coffee shop in Paris, when he executed his suicide belt, okay? Now, this is connected to the notion of theater of terrorism, but he chose the way that the world will remember him, okay? So this is a very personalized way of expression, let's say. The third level is the connective action independent organizations. And to this level, I will connect the notion of lone wolves. It means that we have people who are very oriented in social media. They know the apps, they know how to use all kinds of apps and devices, etc., and mobiles, and they express themselves very freely, and they know how to run from device to device, from app to app, etc. They don't need the approval or the statement to be part of the big organization. They don't have to say, "I'm an ISIS." And sometimes the attack itself is the manifestation to say, "I'm ISIS," okay? They don't have to pledge, but the way they want to give their statement is by saying, "I'm doing an attack." So they are the generation of what we call the UGC, the UGC, just a minute, okay? And for example, if we take the Nice attack, okay? The Nice attack, the Muhammad Boulel, when he came to the promenade to gather information about the promenade and how many people are walking in this promenade of Nice, he saw a camera and he stood before the camera knowing that he will be shoot and he will be die and everything, but when the intelligence forces will do their reverse engineering of all the cameras all around, they will see him and they will point on him and know and recognize the figure that made the attack. And even though he preferred to do it like a provocative expression of himself, okay? And we have another example of the perpetrator from the Berlin attack, who after it was an imitation an attack after Nice, and he did the same way. And when he ran away from the arena, he saw a camera. He stood before the camera, knowing that he's running from the police and other forces, but he chose to stand before the camera and say, I'm here, and the F word. This was his message. So the lone wolves all over the places, they don't have to pledge to ISIS or Al-Qaeda or other organizations, but the manifestation comes from the act itself, the attack itself, the terror attack, which is like a theater of terrorism, because they choose the place, the location, the time, the arena, sometimes it's a holiday time, etc. This way of expression frame all the content that they are articulating. This is the articulation of terrorism and how I, as a individual, choose to express myself. Okay? Thank you.
Thank you.
You're welcome.